Heartiest welcome to this value-added program on data mining and data analytics. Dear students, today we are going to learn about the chemical and material data searching. Okay. So yesterday we have seen how we search the text data or numeric data, but today because we have the student from the different background, from the BTech chemical engineering or material science or pharmacy background, okay, so there we need to search about the chemicals and how this information and data is represented in the database, because there are specific notations, there are some specific notations and dictionary that are used in the representation of those molecules. So that information and data we cannot process like any textual information or numeric data. So their representation is different. So we have different kind of databases and tools for the chemical and materials. So today in this lecture we are going to discuss about that. Okay. So this is our value-added program on data mining and data analytics, and today we are discussing the topic of searching in chemical and material database. So this is chemical representation, okay, means representation of 2D structure, you can say, of the molecule. So here you can see the molecular graph of this structure. Like this is the graph of acetic acid structure. So in the database the molecules are represented in the form of graph. So here you can see, okay, chemical representation of molecule in chemical database in 2D substructure. So 2D substructure searching is related to this. I will come later on this topic. So there is an American Chemical Society that contain more than 18 million compounds. Okay. And database also contain the virtual molecules. Virtual molecules means that molecules do not yet exist, but this can be synthesized using the combinatorial chemistry approach. Okay. So the data related to the chemical, it is represented in the form of graph and nodes. Okay. Graphs and nodes. So which are connected by edges. So in the computer, within the computer, the chemical structures are saved as, okay, so it is in the form of nodes and edges. And if we talk about the part of that structure, chemical compound, so that will be represented by the subgraph. So subgraph is a subset of nodes and edges of the graph. So in this figure you can see, are you able to see, are you able to see now? Hello. So this is the graph structure for the molecule, graphical structure for the molecule. So molecule can be represented as a graph. Like you can see here, we can see the nodes and edges. We can see the another figure. So there may be the subgraph related to the main structure. So the structure can be divided into subpart or subgraph. So how the molecules are represented in the computer, that is in the form of graph. Okay. Somebody is here. I request everybody to join through the Google Classroom. So please join the Google Classroom if you have the link in your group. You all have the link in the group, you can join through the Google Classroom. So this is the representation of the okay, so we were here. This is chapter number 12, chemical database searching. So database contains so many structure, more than 18 million compounds. So here you are looking at the example. This is the model structure, means this is the graph contain nodes, and these are connected by edges. So this is the completely connected graph. On the right hand side you can see the completely connected graph has an edge between all pairs of nodes. Okay, and on the left hand side we can see the graph. This is not completely connected. So this is the way of representation, a subgraph of the graph of acetic acid. Okay, this is that. A graph is said to be completely connected if that is connected between the all pairs of nodes. So only in the rare cases the molecule will be the connected graph. Okay, completely connected hoga, ye bahut hi rare cases mein hoga aisa. So there is the number of the different ways that the molecular graph can be communicated between computer and end user. So when we do the searching in the chemical database, generally the graph is compared. How the comparison is done in the computer, the graphs are compared with each other. The nodes are compared, the node to node comparison. Okay, and there are the certain tools. Using those tools we can draw the chemical structure, we can create the new molecule also. So for each graph there is a connection table. If we do the searching in the database, so there is a connection table. Like for the acetic acid, so there is a connection table for the molecular design and mol format, and there are the different formats that we can use. So here you can see this is the molecular graph of acetic acid. In this figure you can see this is the molecular graph of acetic acid structure. So here you can see on the right hand side how we will represent the acetic acid in the graphical form. Okay, you just take the note, you just draw the structure on your copy also, how you should represent the acetic acid structure in the graphical form, like C1 C2. So on the right hand side you can see the structure, normal structure of the acetic acid, and on the right hand side you can look the how acetic acid is represented in the computer or in the database. So this is the way of the representation. We represent the chemical structure in the form of graph. Are you able to see that? Okay, if anybody has question can ask at the middle. I think everybody should join. I'm a BTech chemical student, MSME. Okay, now come to the next one. So there is a number, the information that is written data you can say. There is a number of bonds like 3, the number of atoms 4. Okay, so there is a specific format for the chemical structure. So we can represent the, like C, this is the atom number 1, this is a carbon atom, CC, okay, OO, that is the oxygen atom, okay, we can represent. Number of bonds we can write down, how many number of bonds are here. So bond between the atoms 2 and 3 is a single. So this is the bond block. So in this way we represent the information, okay. So this is how we represent the data information, sorry. So this was the example of acetic acid. Now here, okay, so we can see this is the MDL mole format for acetic acid in the hydrogen suppressed form. Okay, so for the actually in the computer databases we have different kind of format like SDF dot mol format, okay, SMILE format. If we have the, we can represent the two dimensional structure in the single sentence also using the SMILE format, but this is the mol format, this is the mol file for the acetic acid and that is in the hydrogen suppressed form. So there are the different format, but SMILE format is popular and the dot mol format, this is also popular. But if we need to dock or if we need to dock the structure of the drug with the protein molecule, then we need the SDF format also. Okay, so you can download the structure in the SDF format also when we do the searching in the chemical database. Okay, so there is another format also like methane we can represent in the computer using C. And ethane is represented as CC and propane, that is a triple C, okay. And 2-methoxycyclohexane is like 2-methyl propane, that is like CC, bracket mein phir se humne C likha hai, than C. So this is the format 2-methyl propane. Now another one is cyclohexane, the format for that is C1, C, 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 1. Okay, so note the use of the integer means jo number hota hai 1, 2, 3, integer to indicate the right bond. Okay, so it is written here like benzene we will write C1, then 5 times C1. Acetic acid, how we will write it? CC, then ब्रैकेट में हम लिखें, अगर कोई बॉन्ड है तो वहाँ पर हम ब्रैकेट लगाते हैं, ठीक, डबल बॉन्ड ओ. सो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर एसिटिक एसिड, दिस इज कॉल्ड SMILE फॉर्मेट. सो इन द सिंगल सेंटेंस वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट द केमिकल मॉलिक्यूल. ओके, एंड इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द ज्योमेट्री, ओके, स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री एंड ज्योमेट्री, इट इज ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज कैन ऑल्सो भी इंक्लूडेड इन द SMILE नोटेशन लाइक. ओके, सो वी आर गिविंग हियर द बॉन्डिंग स्ट्रक्चर, ऑल्सो वी कैन नॉट सी द टू डायमेंशनल स्ट्रक्चर, दैट वी कैन सी मीन्स यूजिंग द मोल फॉर्मेट और SDF फॉर्मेट वी कैन विजुअलाइज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑल्सो. बट SMILE फॉर्मेट इज़ वेरी यूजफुल इन सेविंग द स्ट्रक्चर एंड डिटेल्स कैन बी इंक्लूड, नोटेशन कैन बी इंक्लूडेड लाइक स्टीरोकेमिस्ट्री एंड ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज कैन ऑल्सो भी इंक्लूडेड इन द SMILE नोटेशन. सो वन फीचर ऑफ बोथ द कनेक्शन टेबल एंड द SMILE स्ट्रिंग, वॉट इज दिस? सो इन मैनी, देर आर मैनी डिफरेंट वेज टू रिप्रेजेंट द सेम मॉलिक्यूल. सो द वन वे, सो द वन चूज टू द नंबर. ओके, वी कैन चूज द नंबर atoms in the connection table in the different order or to write the SMILE in the differently. Okay, so here you can see, So this is the one way. This is the smile format. You can see. You can learn this one. Like for methane it is C, for ethane it is double C. So this is the canonical representation of the structure. So we use the smile format for this. Now we are moving from. So here you can see for the different structure we have the this information and data in the numbers. So. So there is the use of the different types of algorithm to perform the search, like the Ullman algorithm using 4 atoms substructure and 6 atom molecule. The proposed match is shown in the bottom figure together with the relevant matrix. So there are the different computational algorithm that are used for the searching. So one of them is Ullman algorithm, that is using a 4 atom substructure or 6 atom substructure for the search. So here you can see in the above figure. So the part of the substructure is used for the searching, like 4 atom or 6 atom searching. We can do the searching using the different atom. So here how the information is saved in the database. It is in the form of 0 and 1. So it is the bit code, okay, that can be easily compared. So that the data can be easily compared to retrieve the information. Okay. So processing of data is done to retrieve the information. So because we need the information, we can't remember the code and everything. So we need the information. But within the computer, there is a limited space. So we need we have certain specific notation that are used to save the chemical structure in the computer. So matrix is made according to that. So whatever you are seeing, that is a matrix. Okay. The purpose of this lecture is to show you the how the molecules are represented in the database, how we can represent the chemical molecules in the databases. So we cannot save this information and data like other textual what we search in the Google. Okay. So that is not like that, because chemicals have the specific structure and specific arrangement, configuration and conformation. So Ullman algorithm is one of that. Now come to the like 3D database searching. So in the 2D database searching, we use the part of the graph, like subgraph for the searching. So in the 2D searching, what we do, like if there is the alcoholic structure, so we use the OH. We used to type the OH in the 2D database searching. We will type OH, retrieve the structure that have the OH group. So when we type the OH group, it will retrieve the relevant alcoholic structure which have the this group, okay, OH group. So this is called substructure searching. So that will only compare the OH, the structure which have the OH group in their structure. Now there is the 3D database searching that is done on the basis of the disconnected fragment or combination of feature. So on the basis of the different fragments, the structure can be identified. So obviously the whole structure cannot be compared at one time. So we divide the different types. So we divide the structure in the different parts for the searching. And we search for the molecules. For suppose our purpose is to find out the molecule with the biological activity. Okay. So substructure is the disconnected fragment, we can say. So it doesn't have something. So in the 3D database searching, one try to find the molecule that satisfy the chemical and geometric requirement of a receptor. Suppose we have the receptor, we have the target protein, and we want to discover a drug for that. So we are looking in the 3D database searching, we are looking for the structure that can fit to this receptor. So sometimes the fragment of the structure can fit to the receptor. Suppose there is a complete compound, it can be fitted to the receptor. So we are interested in that. So So sometimes it works, sometimes doesn't, but we use the further docking process for if we are unable to find out the suitable molecule. Okay. So 3D database contain information about the conformational properties and functionality features of the molecule. Okay. So that is the, so we are searching for the 3D molecule, we are searching for the chemical drug that can work against the receptor. So that is our purpose of 3D searching. So it may be possible to detect the pharmacophoric group also, because 3D structure is helpful to detect the pharmacophore, that is active part of the drug which interact with the receptor. So this search is also useful in finding the pharmacophore or that interact with the receptor. Okay. So this is the next topic, driving and using the three dimensional pharmacophore. So pharmacophore, what is pharmacophore? Pharmacophore, okay, for a series of active compounds. So means active part of the drug. So the 3D pharmacophore specifies the special relationship between the groups, okay, that can work, that is involved in the activity. Suppose the example is given here, the 3D pharmacophore for antihistamine contain two aromatic ring and tertiary nitrogen distributed as shown in the figure. Okay, so the example has been given like here. Okay, these are some common biosteric group. I think the example has been given for antihistamines. Need to look for. So what pharmacophore indicate? That indicate the key features of series of active compounds. Like if we compare the different types of drugs that belong to the same category. So why we call that belong to the same category? That means they have the same type of pharmacophore. So pharmacophore is similar in the same class of drug. Okay. So if we do the comparison, if there is a common part, common subgraph that are matching with each other, and the molecules, different molecules have the same chemical structure, that means the pharmacophore is same for those types of drug. And if there is a stereochemical properties are similar, we call them the bioisosteres atoms, means for which the functional groups or molecules with similar physical and chemical properties. Okay, means their properties, physical chemical properties are similar, so they produce generally the similar biological activity. So in the drug designing, we are looking for that. Okay, so these are the examples. And there is a more complex search also. I don't want to go into the details, but now we'll search in the database. We'll understand this using the. Like suppose in the database ChemSpider. Okay, this is the I have opened. Here we have tools also, we can search the information. Okay, now we are looking for, now we are going to do search in the ChemSpider. Okay, suppose I am typing the simple molecule glucose. Okay, are you able to see, are you all here? Glucose. Okay, now I have typed glucose here. So here you can see how many structures are given here. Okay. I have typed the glucose in the as the searching keywords. Okay. I can save this as a snapshot because we are doing the practicals on this. Okay, I have typed the glucose in the as the searching keywords. Okay. For the reference, I am saving this page. You can see it clearly. Now we have the, I have typed the glucose as the searching keyword. Now there is the result that are showing the glucose structure, different glucose structure in the answer. Okay, here we have filter option, so we can use that also. So these are all the structure, all the glucose structure. Are you able to see? I'm increasing the size. Okay. So these are all structures. You can look at these. So molecular weight is given here, molecular formula is given here, structure is given here, reference is also given here. There is a PubMed reference. You can search about the literature of this molecule also. Save one more picture here. So these are our result for the reference, so that you can do the assignment. Your today's assignment will be based on this. Okay. So now you can see. Okay, so here you can see these are the different glucose structure that are being shown here. Some have the similar structure, formula is same, but their conformation may vary. So in each structure you can see what is the difference between the stereochemistry and special arrangement of the atoms. So you can see the difference between. So you can look at each structure and the formula is the same, but molecular weight is also same, but there is a difference in the structure also. So you, here you can look, these are the different glucose structure. I think molecular formula is same. So we can call these the biostereosol. Okay. So you need to see what are these. You need to analyze. Now filter option has also been given here. You can filter, search single component structure only, search multi component structure only. So you can modify the search, you can do the filtration here. Filtration you can do. single, you want to use a single component structure or multi component structure. So it's up to you. Okay, you want the single component structure or multi component structure. Okay, we can take the result. Like if I click on that, I'm searching again. Searching limit has been given as 100. Now it is searching. Okay, so here these are the single component search. I think it is like previous one. Okay, so you can take out the output and you can grow the comparison. This is the result for the single. Okay, single component search. Okay, so I can save this single component search. Okay, so this is the result of single component search. Here, so you can see it by increasing size. Okay, this has been given. So this is the result of single component search. It is written here. So if we want to go into the detail, we can look. Okay, there is a hand. Wherever there is a hand, we can click on that. It will lead to you on the next page. So for this first entry, now we there is a result of 12. I mean we have 12 results for this. Okay, so here you can see this is the when we have clicked on the first entry. Okay, you can comment on this record also. You can do much more. So this is about the beta D glucopyranose. Okay, this is the structure of this. Molecular formula has been given here. Molecular formula has been given here. Average mass has been written here. Mono isotopic mass is given here. Chem spider ID is given here. This is the database ID provided by the database. I think now it is clear for you, and there are the different signs are written here. Like if you want to save the structure, you can save. You want to see the 3D format, you can do. You can increase the size also. So on the PPT we are looking now, but okay, if you want to save this structure, you can save. This is the actual. Suppose this is the symbol to save. If we want to save the structure, so we can save this structure. Suppose this is our value added post, and what is the ID has been given here. This is the glucose structure. What is the name of this? Okay, beta D glucopyranose. डी ग्लूको पायरेनोज. ओके सो आई एम सेविंग दिस स्ट्रक्चर फॉर द रेफरेंस. सो दिस इज द प्रैक्टिकल वी आर डूइंग बीटा डी ग्लूको पायरेनोज. वी आर सेविंग दिस स्ट्रक्चर. What you can do, you can click on this 3D okay, battery is low. I need to plug. Okay, 3D structure is not now visible, but we can save the structure. If we are saving the structure, we can visualize that structure in the visualization tool. Okay, that we will do in the next class also. We will have another class on the visualization of the chemical molecule. Okay, so sometimes the tools are available are linked with the databases, and we can visualize the structure on that platform. So now I think there will be the problem. So the structure is not displayed. Only 2D structure is displayed. The detail has been written here. Okay. Here you can see this is the beta D glucopyranol. So these all are the details that has been written here. Like you can save this detail, and there is the many more detail also. The names has been written here. Okay. So this is about the nomenclature also. What is the nomenclature? More detail. It is the nutrient. It is the hexose class. So if you click on this, so you will find the detail okay, how it is related to the hexose and nutrient category. Okay, a reference will be given here. Okay, so it is now it is linked to the Chabi reference. It is four component. You can save this result also here. So for the practical reference we are saving. So your assignment will be based, your today's assignment will be based on this. Okay, just and this type of search is useful for the pharmacy student, biotechnology students, for everybody, because drugs, if you want to search for the drug, and drug are supposed to be act against the protein. So this is important. This information is important for you. Okay. So by clicking on the different parameters, you can search the different kind of information here. Okay. Like on the properties, if you click on the properties, you can find out. Okay, like what is the melting point, it is given here. Okay, then click on the boiling point, you want to see experimental optical rotation. So in the log P, suppose we are interested, that is this data is important for, this information is important for the drug designing. Okay, log p value is this. So the value of the partition coefficient should be between 1 to 5 to act as a drug. Okay, flash point, experimental density. So different kind of information we can have. So these all the informations are related to melting point, boiling point, so we can save this kind of search also. Save the information about optical rotation. Okay, it is given here. So the information is provided here. You can look at this. You can go into the more details by clicking on the okay, like suppose if you want to see look for the more information about like log p value, what is this? If you will click on this, then we will get more information. Need to know whether internet is working. It is working. This time this is not connected with. Now we are clicking on this optical rotation. Just see what information we get. So this information is very useful if you are working on the chemicals, like chemical reactions also, this information is useful. For the chemical reactions, we have another database like pathway and reaction database. For the beta chemical engineering, it is very important. So this is the reference related to the stereochemistry. So we can save this information. The log p value, the property is given here. The source is given here. Predicted properties are given here. All the properties. So you can look. Okay. We can. Further, we are also getting the detail about the structure and other properties. Okay. So we are able to see the structure now, synonym and property also. We can save the properties from here. Source is also given here, A log PS, this is calculated by them. So properties. So we can save. We can save the properties of the molecule. This molecule. Okay. So the properties has been given here. I think you all are able to see this. By increasing the size, we can see. Are you all able to see water solubility is given here? Property value. These are given. Log P values are given here. Log S. Okay. pKa strongest acidic or strongest basic. So all have been given here. Physiological charge is given here, zero. Hydrogen acceptor count, hydrogen donor count, polar surface area, rotatable bond count, refractivity, polarizability, number of rings, bioavailability. Yes, it is bioavailable for human body. Means how much means it is available to human also, protein also. Yes, it is available. Tags. So glucose is generally easily available. This is the source of instant energy. So bioavailability is more in this case, glucose. Instantly we get the energy from the glucose. Rule of 5 work on this? Yes. Okay. Weber's rule. So there are the different types of information. This is given here. Chemical formula is also given here. IUPAC name is also given here. Okay. So this is the same information. So we are okay. This is a database like food B. Okay. Oh, now we are on the another platform from the Chem Spider. Now we are on the another platform. Okay. So there's the different types of information that we are getting, from which class it belongs. Super class, organic oxygen compounds, organo oxygen compounds. So there is a subclass also, carbohydrate and carbohydrate conjugates. So different types of information has been given here. Ontology is also given here. Route of exposure, how we take and how we okay. Ingestion, endogenous food, biologically, okay. So there are the different plants from which we can obtain biological. Location, cytoplasm mein hota hai, biofluid. So these are the sources in which we can detect the glucose level, and there are the some industrial application of this role hai. Role, there is a role in the pharmaceutical industries. Physicochemical properties, experimental has been given here. These are all experimental properties. Okay, these are empirical data. So above we have showing you the predicted data, that was the computationally predicted, but this is the empirical data which has been given here. So all the data have been provided here. There's a lot of information which is given here. MSMS information related to the mass spectrum. So this is the another database. Actually we were on the Chem Spider, okay? We were searching in that, but we can save this for the reference. This is the searching that we are doing in the food B database. Okay? We can save the complete page of this as a PDF, okay? Because this is the another database we are looking here. So I'm just saving it for this reference, for the practical, what we are doing for you, so that you can do the assignment. Okay. Now I'm closing this page because I want to come on the Chem Spider page. So the all information we got. So this is the link food B FODB is the another database. We have searched in the FODB also. So by clicking on each one, you can, and there are the different types of those. We can do the different type of search also. This is related to CamSpider. Okay. Spectra, you can look. No Spectra is found. So anybody can work. He or she can make available the, can ensure the availability of Spectra. They can do the more research, vendors. And there are many more options. Pharma. References are given here. Data sources are given here. You can look at here. Okay. Now I am moving back to. So if we click on the, what happened? If we click on the structure. So this is the structure that has been given, and you can draw the structure also. You can import that structure also. Experimental. You can load the previous structure if you have that. Suppose we have the structure. I am just looking, the file is available, whatever we have saved, the file is available or not. I am just looking. Okay, so now I have imported this structure. Now you can look here on the structure search. I have clicked on that. By clicking on the load structure, okay, yahan pe maine click kiya tha, structure search hum log kar rahe hain, yahan pe maine click kiya, then I will upload this PPT for your reference so that you can study each and every step. That will be easy for you. This is the structure search we are doing. Okay, and we can draw our unknown structure also. We can draw the new structure. Okay, but we have just loaded the structure what we have saved. Previously I have saved one structure in front of you, glucopyranose structure. We have saved the first entry, single component search we have done. Then we have saved the structure of beta D glucopyranose. Okay, now the structure has been loaded on this platform. Okay, here you can see, are you able to see? Sorry. So you can make some changes also. I don't know. Okay, for a reference. Structure search, we have explored this, we have imported the structure of glucopyranose here. Okay, now if you want to change this structure, you can do the change. You can design your own molecule, you can convert it into the different format also. So you can do this type of work here. Suppose you want to convert this into you want to save it into the different. Okay, on the convert structure I have click on that. Okay, so there we are getting the different options. And we can do the substructure searching, exact searching, similar to those molecules. Substructure search you can do from here. Filtering we can do. Come on, but I'm just clicking on that. I'm just looking what will be the result of this searching. So now here you can see there are the 100 result of substructure search. Okay, for this molecule now we have 100 results. These are all the results of the results that we are getting out of this search. You can reduce the size, you can take the whole picture. Here also you can click on whatever you want to do, you can proceed. So using this glucose structure, we have done the two dimensional substructure searching. So substructure searching, what is that? So it fragments are used, the fragments of structure are used for the searching. On the basis of that, we are getting so many structures to whom the fragments are matching. Here you can see we have the different kinds of structure here. Okay, so these are looking similar to this, more similar to this. The above panel we are getting the structure that are more similar to this. Now here we also have the structure in which the part are matching. These are the different structure, but the fragments are matching, substructures are matching here. So you have loaded this structure, you can convert the structure, means you can search, you can do some, and you can also perform the substructure similarity search also. Okay, let's do the similarity search. Tanimoto coefficient, because you don't know about the Tanimoto, so these are all the descriptors of physical properties of the drugs. So we need to study more about this. Molecular weight is given here, molecular formula. Now just we are looking for the similarity search. We are just doing the similarity search. Now we are getting the result of the similarity search. Just now. It will take some time. It will appear, okay? No problem. Now we have the result of similarity search. Okay. It's to you. You can restrict the search also. You can do the 100 or so. These are the results of similarity search. If you have the laptop or in your mobile also, you can do this type of search. So now we have explored the result of the substructure searching and similarity. Okay, by the similarity, so these are the molecules. So here you can see what is the difference between the result of the substructure searching and similarity. In the substructure searching, we can get the different molecule also, but in the similarity search, we will find out the similar molecule only. Okay, that are similar to glucose. So that is the difference. Saving the, you can do the comparison between the results of substructure searching and similarity search. Okay, so these are all results. Further, if you want many more information, we can click on the data sources. So because we have only seen how we should download the data, so you can click on here, you can download that, you can see the reference. If you click on the data sources, that will lead to the sources. Okay, so now we have explored the results of so the options we have for the bond, for ring, for whatever we want, which atom we want to introduce in this structure, we can do that. This is the I'm just saving this. This is the glucose structure that we have imported. Okay, now if you want to make the any change, we can do here. Whatever we, if you want to play this structure, if you want to remove, if you want to attach any atom, you can attach here. Okay, whatever you want to do, you can do. Okay, whatever you want to do. So you can create your own molecule. Okay, like as I have put it here, you can also do this bond you want to create. So you can create the bond. Okay, you can add any other atoms. So benzene ring, if you want to introduce, you can. So you can do some meaningful. I'm just randomly I'm using this, but you can create your own molecule. You can do some modification in this. That should not be random. You can do the meaningful changes. How you can do? You can look for on the similar molecule. You can look at the similar data, and then you can do the changes. So how we should change the structure of this molecule to create the drug or efficient molecule. Okay. So whatever you want to do, you can do it here. Okay, yeah, so if you want to take the this molecule, then we can attach it. Okay, print screen, I'm taking. So if we want to change the structure, we can change that structure. and we can save it again. Okay, this is just modified. I'm just okay typing modified structure. So you can learn by doing the modification in that, and you can save that, and you can calculate the property of this drug also, of this molecule. You can do the prediction for that. Okay, it can be done in the different database also, like mole inspiration. You can do the calculation of the properties. Just look at this, if this can be executed or not. Here I'm just looking if this can be done or not. I'm just doing the similarity search. Okay, what happened? Okay, net is working. Now it is not running. Okay, I think there will be some problem. And I have created the different kind of molecule. It may not be following the rule of chemistry. Okay, so we should do the meaningful change. Okay, so you can save this structure. You can draw the structure. You can save the structure. You can clean whatever you have done. You can clean and you can do the another. You can create your own molecule. Why it is not working now? Now just I'm going back so that we can do some another kind of searching. So this was all the single component search which we have explored. In the same way you can do, and filtering you can do from here, like you can do the multi component search also. If I'm cleaning, it should be cleaned. It is not working. So using the glucose keyword, I have started this search. So from here, from using the filtration, now you can do the multi-component search also. You can explore the multi-component search, or you can filter the data only those having the analytical data. If the entry has the analytical data, that will be explored. Otherwise, it will not. So you can select multiple things. This type of searching you can do multi-component structure only, and the only those who have the analytical. So we can do the searching from here. So now we are exploring the multi-component search. So initially we have explored the single component search, but the parameter will be same. Okay, so you can click on that and you can search in that one by one, and you can save the results. You can compare the results. You can create your own molecule. You can do some changes. You can import the structure. You can save the structure, then you can load that structure in the software, then you can draw, you can make some changes also. So I have also opened the drug bank. In the drug bank also we have the Marvin sketch tool. So from using that we can create our own structures, just like I have shown you on this platform. Now it is moving. So are you able to listen? Do you have any question you can ask? Okay, this is taking some more time. We are going on the another discussion. Okay, so okay, so time is very less now, huh? You need the break also, and there will be another lecture also. So in the short I am telling you, so this is the MATWeb, another tool, another database that I am taking, that is for the material science student. Anybody can search in this MATWeb homepage. So you need to register here to download any file. I try to download the Excel file. So you need to register on this website to download any file related to any material. So you can do. So this is the homepage of the MATWeb. Okay. From here you can you can perform the different kind of search, like quantitative search and categorized search. So this is the homepage. So for the material information. So it include the data sheets of the thermoplastics, thermoset polymers such as ABS, nylon, polycarbonate, polyester, okay, polyethylene and polypropylene, metals such as aluminium, cobalt, different types of metal like lead, magnesium, nickel. So you can search about the information of these and the semiconductor materials like fibers and other engineering materials that can be used to engineer. Okay, so here we can do the different type of searching. Like I have used the ceramic keyword, I have typed the ceramic, then I got this page. So I got the relevant search output related to that. Okay, so here on in the output page you can see, can watch here, this is the result of when I use the keyword ceramic. Okay, so there are total 7497 materials that are found. So you can check which one is suitable for you, or you can restrict your entry, you can do some customized search also. So here you can see we have the different kinds of material like alumina, thick film alumina, opaque alumina. So what different kinds of alumina are found, so it is given. Okay, so here on this page we can find, we can see the output of the ceramic search that we have done in the MATWeb, okay, using ceramic keyword. Okay, by clicking on the first entry we are getting the more information about this, like corundum, aluminum oxide, so we can, whatever we are looking for we can see. So metric is given here, chemical properties are given here, mechanical properties are also given here, and this is not the complete page, this is just the upper panel. Okay, so here you can see the physical part, this is the bottom result. Okay, when I explore the search, so we got the information about physical properties, then chemical properties, mechanical properties, so everything has been given here. For any molecule, if you want, you are doing any project on any molecule, so you can search here. Okay, for semiconductor, for anything, whatever you are doing, you can search whatever material you are using, And if you want to do only the computational work, you can also do. There are certain platforms that you can use for that. So molecular information, the information about the materials are available here. And we are doing the search for ceramic. I have used the ceramic keyword for searching, and now we are having the output related to the ceramic. So I have clicked. I have used the word ceramic, then I got so many entries, then I have clicked on the first entry, that is corundum aluminum oxide, okay, aluminum. So here we are looking for the information. You can see the physical properties, information about the physical properties. So everything has been given here. On the single page we are getting all the information, chemical properties, mechanical properties. So everything has been given here. It will give you the information about what physical property, like water absorption, lattice constant, lattice molecular weight, chemical property like molar volume, mechanical property like hardness. Okay. Tensile strength. So you can have idea which molecule you are going to use in your research or in engineering. So you can analyze before using that material. You can look how it will work. Electric properties has also been given here. I'm just exploring. It has been given here. Now we can do the property search also. You can give your own value on using this page. You can give your parameter, you can do the selection, you can do the minimum, you can type here minimum and maximum limit of unit. You can use the metric. If you do not have the idea, you can use that search. You can look at there what metric has been given. You can use that metric here to specify your search. And on the left hand side you can select the material like carbon, ceramic, anything you want. Within the carbon also we have so many multiple categories. If I click on that ceramic, we have different kind of category. After that you have to click on find, then you will get the result. Okay. So from here you can see if you can click on carbon, ceramic, anything you want. So on the left hand side you can click any one of that, and within this parameter you can specify. So now by doing that we are getting this. Okay, this is the output of this search. So this is the category search that we have done. There are different types of search has been given here. On the MedWeb search we can do the different types of searching like quantitative search and categorized search. So you can do the quantitative search also, and you can do the categorized search also. So these are the different types of searching mode here on the MedWeb. In the quantitative search we have physical, we can do a searching about the physical properties, alloy composition, and you can do the advanced searching. For advanced searching you need the registration. If you want to save the data also, you can save the data in the Excel file, PDF or anything, but you need the registration for that. So once you get registered you can download the data also. Categorized search, within the categorized search we have the material type searching, manufacturer name, trade name, number. So these are the different kind of searching that we can do. So these are the different types of searching that we can perform on the MATLAB. This is the home page and this is the result of the ceramic search. Now this is the information about the corundum aluminium oxide. Okay, if we further explore, I have further explored this search, so I got this data, physical properties. So here on this page we have the information about physical properties, chemical properties, mechanical properties and electrical properties. So that is very useful for the chemical background student, for the electrical also. So this information is useful. You can do the property search also. You can type your metric or parameter here on the right hand side, then you can click on the left hand side within the any category, carbon, ceramic, which kind of molecule. So here there are many more. Just scroll down, so you will get the more types of molecules. So by doing that search, then we are getting the different kinds of molecules. Doing the category, if we do the category search, so that is the result of that. Okay, so this is the another result of the another search, like Kumar, Tech, Bismuth, Silicon Oxide. So now we have the information about the physical properties, electrical properties, okay, of the different molecule related to the ceramic. So in the ceramic we have the different kinds of once you will start your search, it will give you so many options. All the entries will be provided on the first page. From there you need to select anyone or in which you are interested. You can explore your search depending on your interest. So we can do the advanced search also. For advanced search, you need to register in the database. Then you can retrieve the information and you can save the information. You can do the different types of customized search. Now also you can do the search, but you are not able to save the data. And there are the different types of tools also that are available there. So here you can see units of measure converter. So you can convert, you can type the unit measure here and you can convert that into the another format. Okay, so this is the tool for the to convert the unit of measure. Okay, so here you can see you convert from this PSI to PA. Okay, so it will be converted like gram, percent, cubes, cubic centimeter. So it will be converted into the, okay. So you can convert from anything like joule to calorie. So you can, this is the unit converter and you can see. So this will be very helpful for you. Okay. Unit of measure converter. So this is the important for, if you are using, you are doing the engineering of anything, semiconductor or anything. Okay, and we have another tool, engineering shape weight calculator here. Okay, engineering shapes weight calculator. So in the MATLAB we have the automatic weight calculator for sheet, plate, tube, bar and other engineering material. Okay, so you can select anything. So you can select from here, the options are given here. Okay, and you can type the parameter also if you have. Okay, whatever you want, you can customize your search. Then that will be everything will be calculated. So calculate button is given here. Using that calculate button, you can explore your whatever you want to design. Okay. So using the appropriate dimensions, so you need to provide the thickness, width, the length, you can provide here. Then it will calculate. So engineering shape. So it will calculate the shape of the material, shape of whatever you want to do. So you just provide the dimension here, it will give you the shape. The output will be the whatever you are able to see on the right hand side, that is the shape, that will be the output. So it is available for the registered user. So this is a very helpful search for the material science student as well as for the electrical background students. Now there is another tool on this MATWAVE platform. We have another tool, that is online hardness converter tool. Okay, means this is the MATWAVE online hardness converter for engineering material, is only available to registered user. Okay, so enter the value you wish to convert. You can select the material type and hardness test from scale such as like Brinell, no, Vickers, Rockwell. Okay, you just press convert. So conversion is computed against numerical correlations based on the empirical data, means experimental data. The calculation, it is done on the basis of empirical data. So this is online hardness converter tool. The prediction, whatever is done here, that is not purely based on the computational tool. They are using the computational tool, but using the empirical data, using the experimental data, okay, so that the prediction can be more useful for you. Okay, so thing you can see here, hardness test, hardness value. Okay, so the value that are shown in the red color, that are marginal points. Please be aware of the data. Okay, so the data cannot be may not be as accurate within the range. Okay, so you can exclude that red data. Okay, the data that is in the range you can use, it is advisable that you should use that values, but this is the computation tool that can be used. It will give you the idea, at least if you are doing work on the five molecules, so it can give you the idea about the on which you should work, which you should select. So further we can move in which direction. So it will give you the direction. It will minimize the cost of the experiment also. That is very useful if you are making the five conformation of the same material or five shapes of the same material. So this will give you the idea what you should do. Okay, this is the online hardness converter tool. Now glossary is also available, you can look at there. If you want to look at the definition, you can search here. Okay, and this is the data for the another search, like using the for the carbon. I have done the search using for the carbon. So for carbon we have the data. I have done the two types of searching, like ceramic, one is for ceramic and another one is for carbon. Okay, so metric or minimum maximum value can type, choose up to three material properties. So you can type your own values. I have typed just like that. Okay, you can customize your search, and from the right hand panel you can select which material do you want, then you can click on find and you will get the. Okay, so here you are able to see the different types of the carbon, graphite carbon C, pyrolytic graphite, low temperature isotropic, vitreous carbon. Okay, this is the Martec carbon aerogel. So these are the different types of the carbon, okay, that are sold by the company. So depending on that, so many names are given here. And we can explore the search related to any one of this. If if I click on any one of this, so it will give you the all the details of physical properties, chemical properties, mechanical properties, electrical properties, everything you will get on that page. Okay, without registering here you can get that information. Without registering on this database. So here I have clicked on the carbon first entry or second entry of the carbon. Then I got this information. Okay, here you can see the matrix has been given here. Physical properties, chemical properties are given here. Critical temperature, critical pressure, electronegativity, everything you are getting on the same page. Mechanical properties. Hardness, like tensile modulus. Okay, these are the mechanical properties. Electrical properties have been given. Thermal properties have been. Okay. So this information you can get without registering on the MATLAB. But if you want to work further, you want to use the tools, so you need to register. If you want to download the database, you need to register on the MATLAB. So you can do the registration. On there, okay. Okay, hello, there was a disconnectivity. I think it has been covered. We have done the searching on the MATLAB. Okay, different types of search we have performed, like ceramic and for the carbon molecule we have done the searching, the lecture was also. If you missed anything, that will be covered. The lecture will be available on the YouTube also. I will try to do it today. Okay, if you have any question, you can ask. Hello. Hello. If you have any question, you can ask. Hello. Okay, you just type your attendance in the chat box. Okay, just type your attendance in the chat box.